Hello everyone, so my name is Jason Sims. We are going to be doing a super important drug today. It is going to be on the drug class Artemisinins, which is quite a mouthful, but let's get right into this. So the first main concept that we're going to want to talk about is something called ACT, A-C-T, which stands for Artemisinin Combination Therapy. So what specifically are we going to be using this drug class for? We are going to be using this for malaria, to fight against it. And the parasite that causes malaria is called Plasmodium. Now there's many different strains of Plasmodium. There is Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium alvali, Plasmodium vivax, and other Plasmodium species. Now the strain that we primarily are going to be using these type of drugs for is Plasmodium falciparum. So this is going to be a first line treatment specifically for the Plasmodium strain, Plasmodium falciparum, which is a particularly nasty strain for malaria. Now we did make another video before talking about chloroquine and primaquine. This is going to be different. Now these are not going to be used at all for a prophylaxis. And the reason this drug is not going to be used as a prophylaxis is because of its drug class characteristics. And the one I'm talking about is that it has a short half-life. What is a half-life? So a half-life is the time for a drug that it enters the body and then it gets eliminated or transformed to be inactive. So being that it has a short half-life, that means the drug comes in and goes out or changes to not be active quickly. So the reason why this is important to know is because if a drug has a short half-life, that means that there's going to be a higher chance that there will be resistance being built up by the Plasmodium parasite. Okay, so I keep talking about Artemisinins. Now that term is really a drug class. So it's an umbrella term, you know, covering many different things. In today's medicine, we aren't going to be giving Artemisinins. We're going to be using drugs that are derived, that come from that Artemisinin. So something that has a similar structure that is either synthetic or it's a little bit different to make it more effective. Some of those drugs are going to be artemether, artesunate, or dihydroartemisinin. So because these drugs have a short half-life and we don't want resistance to build up, we are going to be pairing this with a longer-acting anti-malarial drug. And the main one that we're going to be talking about is something called lumefantrine. Now the most prescribed combination of artemisinin and a long-acting anti-malarial drug in the whole entire world, not just America, is going to be artemether lumefantrine, and it comes in one pill combination. So if you're only going to learn one drug about anti-malarials, then that would be the combination that you want to know about. Okay, so it's important to note that this drug is primarily going to be used for Plasmodium falciparum. Now, if you're going to be going to an area or are exposed and trying to be treated for Plasmodium vivax or Plasmodium alvali, you can give Artemisinin therapy, but it is very important that you also have to give primaquine. And that is because malaria has something called latent form. So latent means that the parasite is still in the cells, but it's not currently active. But the problem with this is it can reactivate later on, years later. So we give primaquine to get rid of this latent inactive form, primarily going to be in the liver cells. And if you want to know more about primaquine, I made a whole nother video about that. But going back to ACT Artemisinins. So once again, any Artemisinin drugs are going to be for Plasmodium falciparum. Now, if you have Plasmodium vivax or Plasmodium alvali, we are going to want to give primaquine instead of ACT. Okay, so the first side effects slash adverse effect is something called QT interval prolongation. Now, these drugs can increase the QT interval. We don't need to go into really crazy detail what this means. Just know that the provider has to get an EKG to rule out a prolonged QT interval. And this is just an abnormality on the EKG, which can be fatal. So that's why it's very important to rule this out, because these drugs can increase the QT interval. There can also be neurological symptoms like dizziness, there can be weakness, confusion, sleep disorders. There's also other non-neurological side effects like arthralgia, which means joint pain. You can also have anorexia, which means loss of appetite. Now, one specific unique thing for Artemisinins is going to be something called black water fever. And pretty much it gets its name because this drug can cause hemolysis, which is a breakdown of red blood cells within the body. And this makes sense because that's where the parasite Plasmodium is going to be infecting primarily, is in the red blood cells. So this drug is going to be breaking down the red blood cells, and you may see that you have dark colored urine. And this is because you're going to be seeing the broken down blood cells within your urine. So red and yellow is going to make more of like a brownish tea color, and that's going to be in the urine. So they call this black water fever because, you know, it has like a brownish blackish color. Why this is unique is because the effects of having this dark colored urine can be delayed. Okay, now considering the contraindications, and a contraindication is basically a reason why you should not be giving a patient a drug. Okay, so there's nothing going to be really of relevance for Artemisinins, which is just great to know. We don't have to worry about G6PD deficiency, we don't have to worry about pregnancy like we do with other antimalarial drugs. Just consider the adverse and side effects above, and you know, if you already have those conditions going on, like arthralgia, let's not give this drug because it will make the arthralgia worse. If you already have a QT prolonged interval, let's not give this drug because it will continue to increase the elongation of the QT interval. Okay, let's talk about dosing now. So let's say you have a kidney impairment, we have a liver impairment. Currently, there is no recommendation for changing the dosing for Artemisinins. Okay, and as I just said about the contraindications, pregnancy is going to be A-okay. It's going to be fine to administer this drug. Okay, so we're going to be using this drug for two different levels of severity of malaria. The first one's going to be uncomplicated, and the next one is severe, which we'll get to in a second. So with uncomplicated malaria, you're going to be having symptoms like fever, some joint pain, some confusion. So you're not going to be having any lethal or life-threatening conditions progressing going on. If it's going to be uncomplicated treatment, we're going to be giving these medications as PO, which means per oral, so just a pill by mouth. And as I said before, the most common type of artemisinin is going to be artemether lumefantrine, and it comes in one combination pill. So we're going to be taking it as a pill. It's going to be 20 milligrams of artemether, and it's going to be 120 milligrams of lumefantrine. This is going to be given 2 times daily for 3 days. Okay, now let's say you don't have uncomplicated malaria, but they're coming in with severe malaria, the second severity type. Okay, so this is going to be a lot worse. You're going to be having some organ involvement. They might be completely confused, not aware of their surroundings. Okay, so when this is going to happen, we're not going to be giving PO at first, per oral at first. We're going to be starting with IV ACT therapy. And specifically, we're going to be wanting to give IV artesunate. We give this initially, then we want to give this 12 hours later, and then we want to give this a following 12 hours later. So that would be 0, 12, and 24 hour marks. Now at that point, if the person is capable of being able to take a pill, it is recommended to now switch to the PO form, which would be artemether, instead of keep on going with the IV artesunate. But if they still are not capable of doing a PO just yet, we would give one time daily dosing for a max of 7 days. And at that point, we would give PO artemether again. Okay, so the last thing we're going to be talking about is the drug's MOA, which is mechanism of action, which is basically how does this drug work. So with artemisinins, the main component that causes this drug to be active is something called an endoperoxide bridge, which is basically just two or so oxygens that are connecting together, making a bridge. Okay, so how does this happen? How does this get activated? Now, it's a little complicated. You can read it in my slide, but what happens is iron within infected red blood cells is going to cause this endoperoxide bridge to be activated. This is going to cause something called reactive oxygen species to form. So this drug is going to be acting as a reactive oxygen species, which damages cells. This is going to kill the Plasmodium within the red blood cells. Okay, so this is a little complicated, but in the future, I'm going to make a whole video talking about how Plasmodium infect a host and the life cycle of a Plasmodium, and maybe a summary video of everything together so you can have a better picture. But I wanted to make this a really quick video just on the drugs for ACT, for Artemisinin combination therapy. Alright, so please like this video, please subscribe, please share this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something. Please comment if you did. Alright. See you in the next one.